Okay, boys. Briefing about yesterday, and we will continue immediately for the exercises. I believe all of you are able to hear me. So if you have any questions, you just raise your hand. Yesterday, we finished this table, إعراب الجملة الإسمية. What is the syntax of the noun sentence? إعراب الجملة الإسمية. We said الجملة الإسمية, the noun sentence has two parts, مبتدأ and خبر. And it can become in the three different status, singular, dual, and plural. If the noun sentence comes in the singular form, like here, الطالبة مجتهدة. It is مبتدأ and خبر. مبتدأ, if it is noun sentence, starting, it has مبتدأ and خبر, and it is in the singular form. الطالبة, it will be مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة الظاهرة. So the sign of syntax, it will be الضمة, because the مبتدأ, it is in the singular form. مجتهدة, it will be خبر مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة. The sign of syntax also ضمة, if خبر in the singular form. The sign of syntax, it will be ضمة, if مبتدأ in the singular form. Now here, if we change the status from singular form to dual, dual means مثنى. If مبتدأ is dual and خبر is dual. So this is noun sentence. هذه هي جملة اسمية تتكون من مبتدأ وخبر. Both of them in the dual form. It is مثنى. So الطالبان, it will be مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه, it will be الألف. So مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الألف. Why? Because it is مثنى. مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الألف. الألف. Why? Because it is مثنى. مجتهدان, it will be خبر مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الألف. Here you can see there is ألف. Why خبر مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الألف? Because this خبر is coming dual, مثنى. Here مبتدأ مرفوع, this is مبتدأ, because this is noun starting with the جملة. So جملة means sentence, so it is مبتدأ. So مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الألف. Why here مبتدأ مرفوع بالألف? Because it is مثنى. The last case, if the noun sentence comes in the plural form. If the noun comes in the plural form, like here, المعلمون مجتهدون. المعلمون مجتهدون, it is جملة اسمية, it has مبتدأ, it has خبر. مبتدأ is plural, خبر also it is plural. So in this case, المعلمون, I will say it is مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الواو. The sign of syntax here is واو, because the noun, the مبتدأ, it is plural, لأنه جمع مذكر سالم. مجتهدون also it is خبر. خبر مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الواو. Why واو here? Because خبر is plural, جمع مذكر سالم. This slide, all of you understand or you have a question before we continue to the exercise? If you understand, raise hand. If you have a question, open your mic and ask. Okay, Mukashfi, you want to ask?
No.
You okay with this?
Yes.
Okay. So, في الجملة الإسمية, in the noun sentence, always we have مبتدأ and خبر. In the noun sentence, always we have مبتدأ and we have خبر. Okay? In the noun sentence, always we have مبتدأ and خبر, and always it is مرفوع. Now the sign of syntax, علامات الرفع. علامات الرفع, the sign of syntax. If it is singular, if then مبتدأ and خبر in the singular form, the sign of syntax, it will be a dhamma. If the مبتدأ and خبر, both of them, in the dual form, the sign of syntax, it will be الألف. If the مبتدأ and خبر in the plural form, the sign of syntax, it will be الواو. I need you to copy this table here before we go to the exercise board. And when you finish, just raise hand. I will know that you finished. Copy these three lines. في الجملة الإسمية هناك مبتدأ وخبر. تتكون الجملة الإسمية من مبتدأ وخبر دائما مرفوع. علامات الرفع الضمة في حالة المفرد. الألف في حالة المثنى. الواو في حالة الجمع. Please copy this information and we will go to the second. Nawaz, yes. Open your mic and ask.
Mr. Can you say what again we write?
هذا اللي موجود قدامك يا محمد. في الجملة الإسمية المبتدأ حبيبي في الجملة الإسمية المبتدأ والخبر دائما مرفوع. علامات الرفع الضمة في حالة المفرد. الألف في حالة المثنى. الواو في حالة الجمع. When you finish copying, please raise hand so we will go to the second exercise. John, you finished? Thank you. Nawaz, thank you. Omar, okay. When you finish this, raise hand, boys, so we can go to the second exercise.
No, I'm still doing the thing. You want, can I do a picture?
What, Adnan?
Do a picture, it can write it later.
No problem.
Okay, I'll do it.
I need you to do this here. If you can just take a photo, okay, fine. So boys, please, I need you to finish this so we can go to the second exercise. Raise hand if you finished, please. Omar, you finish or no? Yes. Saleh, Ahmed. Saif, خلصت? Ahmed Nasser?
No.
Okay. Saif?
Mr. Yes, I finished.
يلا شكرا. يلا يا محمد then I will go next. صالح خلص؟ شكرا يا أحمد. محمد نصر خلصنا؟
yes.
شكرا يا محمد. طيب here we have an exercise. I need you to join me and we will do it together. Starting from Nawaz. Read the question. حدد.
حدد المبتدأ حبر.
الخبر. So
الجملة.
Where الجمل التالية. So I will tell you what does it mean. حدد المبتدأ والخبر في الجمل التالية. Which means find which one in the following sentence find which one is مبتدا, which one is خبر. Read number one.
الفرس.
Okay.
شجاع.
شجاع. الفارس شجاع. So which word is مبتدا, which word is خبر? You know المبتدا means what? What is the meaning of المبتدا? Do you know what the meaning of المبتدا?
No.
So I was explaining that many times before.
Oh!
المبتدا is the noun starting of the sentence. الخبر is objectives. So each noun sentence, الجملة الاسمية, which means noun sentence, it has two parts. First part we call it مبتدا, which means starting with the sentence and it comes as a noun. الخبر, it is objectives, comes after the noun. So where is the noun which we call it in Arabic المبتدا in this sentence?
الفارس.
Correct. So this is the noun الفارس. And الخبر.
الخبر شجاع.
شجاع. Thank you. John. Next. John.
Yes.
Read.
الجاع.
Can you raise your voice, please?
الصديقان. الصديقان.
متعاونان. الصديقان متعاونان. So الصديقان, which means two friends, متعاونان, cooperatives. So which one is مبتدا? The noun, where the noun here? الصديقان.
الصديقان.
And where is the khabar?
Ma.
متعاونان. Now here, الصديقان, John, what does it mean? You know what the meaning of صديق? What the meaning of صديق? Omar, what the meaning of صديق?
Friend.
Good. And if I want to say two friends, what I will say?
Sadiqan.
Thank you. Good. Adnan, do next.
Mujtahidun.
Mukarramun. Al-mujtahidun mukarramun. The hard workers will be rewarded. So al-mujtahidun mukarramun. Which one is mubtada? يا عدنان.
المجتهدون.
المجتهدون. And which one is خبر?
مكرمون.
Good. This المجتهدون in which status? Singular or dual or plural?
Plural.
Plural. المجتهدون. Which we call it جمع مذكر سالم. Okay, Adnan. Thank you. Ahmed Saleh, next.
البرد قارس.
البرد قارس. طيب. البرد قارس هذه جملة اسمية. أين المبتدأ?
البرد.
And الخبر?
قارس.
قارس. أحسنت يا أحمد. طيب. هذه الجمل الإسمية في أكثر من حالة, في حالة المفرد الفارس الشجاع, في حالة المثنى, الصديقان متعاونان أو في حالة الجمع المجتهدون مكرمون. Here the status is plural. الصديقان متعاونان. It is مثنى. مبتدأ مثنى and خبر مثنى. الفارس شجاع. جملة اسمية تتكون من مبتدأ وخبر في حالة المفرد. Now here we change to know علامة إعراب المبتدأ والخبر. The sign of syntax in each sentence for مبتدأ which means starting noun and خبر which is objectives in all these sentences. I don't need to tell me which one is مبتدأ which one is خبر. I want you to tell me what is the sign of syntax based on if the sentence is singular or dual or plural. Starting with مكاشفي. يلا يا مكاشفي اقرا اول وحده. مكاشفي ما اسمعك.
المؤمنون.
ايوه. اخوه.
اجو.
اخوه.
اجو.
اخوه. اخوه. المؤمنون اخوه. صح. هذه الجملة في حال هذه جملة اسمية في حالة المفرد أو المثنى أو الجمع.
مثنى.
ايوه
مثنى.
كيف مثنى؟ مؤمنون يعني كل المؤمنون يعني الجمع يا مكاشفي.
بدرس واو.
ايوه أوكي. المؤمنون جمع.
أوكي.
شو علامة إعراب المبتدأ في حالة الجمع؟
واو.
الواو صح. والخبر
اخوان.
ايوه بس شو علامه الاعراب؟ ما علامه اعراب الخبر؟
واو.
صح احسنت. محمد نصر رقم 2.
كلمه ال مش ال
الشمس مشرقه. مشرقة. ما علامة إعراب المبتدأ؟ أول شيء هذه الجملة الإسمية في حالة المفرد أو المثنى أو الجمع.
مفرد.
صح. شو علامة إعراب المبتدأ؟ إذا كان المبتدأ في حالة المفرد فبيكون مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه ماذا؟
الضمة.
أحسنت. والخبر؟
الخبر؟
يا شو علامة إعراب الخبر؟
الضمة.
الضمة كمان صحيح. أحسنت يا محمد نصر. عمر ريد.
الطالبات.
الطالبان.
الطالبان.
مجتهدان.
مجتهدان.
الطالبان مجتهدان. Okay. This noun sentence. هذه الجملة الإسمية. In which status? Singular or dual or plural?
Dual.
صح. So what is the sign of syntax?
الألف.
Very nice, Omar. Thank you. الألف. طيب I need Saif to tell me the last one. Saif وينك؟ Saif you are with me? I cannot hear you. طيب علي سالم اقرأ الجملة هذه. المدرسة
كبير.
صحيح. المدرسة كبيرة. هذه الجملة الإسمية علي مفرد ولا مثنى ولا جمع؟
شو قولها.
المدرسة كبيرة. هذه جملة إسمية صح. Okay. This sentence singular or dual or plural؟ يعني المدرسة كبيرة. احنا نتكلم على مفرد ولا مثنى ولا جمع؟ المدرسة one or two or many؟ علي المدرسة مفرد واحد. او مثنى او جمع؟
انا اقول واحد.
صح واحد يعني singular يعني مفرد. طيب what is the sign of syntax in the singular form for the noun sentence؟ ما علامة إعراب المبتدأ؟ المدرسة مبتدأ كبيرة خبر. What is the sign of syntax if it is singular form؟ المدرسة تو مبتدأ مرفوع وعلامة رفعه what؟
What do you see,
what do you see on top؟ ضمة ضمة we call it الضمة. You see here on top there is ضمة.
نشوف.
Yes, الضمة. And الخبر also if the مبتدأ takes ضمة, خبر will take ضمة. Okay? طيب. Students, I need you please to copy this table here. Then we will go to one more exercise. يلا.
The two of them?
Yes. Yes, all this.
Oh my.
Yell. When you finish, raise hand. So in this exercise, we learn to find out al-mubtada and al-khabar, and also to know the sign of syntax of mubtada and khabar. Alamat i'rab al-mubtada wal-khabar in the three different status. If the noun sentence in the singular form, alamat al-rafa', it will be al-dhamma. If the noun sentence in the dual form, alamat al-rafa', it will be al-alif. If the noun sentence in the plural form, alamat al-rafa', it will be al-waw. Okay? When you finish, boys, please raise hands. Then we will go to do one more exercise. Okay, Mukashvi. Okay, boys, done. Can we go next? If you finish, please raise hand so I will know you finished. سيف وينك يا سيف؟ اوكي عدنان خلصت. علي سالم جاد please finish then we can go to the مرحبا جاد كيفك؟ اهلين اوكي عدنان خلصت؟ جاد كيف حالك؟
الحمد لله.
أهلين حبيبي. هاي بدنا نكتبها، هاي بتفرجينا عشان نعرف شو المبتدأ وشو الخبر ونعرف شو علامة إعراب المبتدأ والخبر. إذا كان المبتدأ والخبر مفرد بتكون علامة الإعراب الضمة اللي بالآخر، إذا كان المبتدأ الخبر في حالة المثنى تكون علامة الإعراب هي الألف، إذا كان المبتدأ and الخبر في حالة الجمع تكون علامة الإعراب الواو. Is it clear for everyone? Good. عدنان, did you finish? جاد, خلاص? Can I go for one more exercise?
مستر أنا أخذت صورته.
أوكي حبيبي. عدنان, I'm still waiting for you. Adnan is not here. Okay, thank you, Adnan. Now, I need to show you this. This is a worksheet for عين المبتدأ والخبر. Okay. عين المبتدأ والخبر في الجمل الآتية ثم اكتبها في الجدول أدنى. عين المبتدأ والخبر. Find the noun and the خبر which is objectives in the following sentence then write it in the following table. I need you to copy this. I know this is different from what we some of them not all of them some of them is different. This will be a good exercise for you to teach yourself that you understanding what I'm saying or no based on No, it's not on the, we need to copy it from here, yeah, Mukashvi. No, it's not in the weekly plan, no. So what I need you to do, I need you to copy this. Then I will give you time, safe, hala, just listen to 1 minute safe. I need you to copy this on your copy book, and I need you to find out which, each sentence, which one is Mubtada, and which one is khabar. To know that, you need to know that the noun sentence, it has two parts. One is noun, starting with the sentence. The second one will be objectives. Al-mubtada, it's the starting noun, and al-khabar is objectives. So what you have to do, you need to copy this, then, after that, I need you to start knowing the meaning. If you know the meaning, you will be able to know which word is noun and which word is objectives. Then you will know how to fill the table below. Did you understand me? So I can do it with you, it is easy, but first I need you to start thinking. This is 6 sentences. It is all noun sentence. كلهم جمل اسمية. So, we learn The jumla ismiya, it has two parts, noun sentence and objectives. So the first word, it's called noun, which is mubtada. The second word, it is objectives, which is khabar. This sentence, it can has also many other words. It's not only one objective. It can be two objectives. It can be more than this. It can be more than noun. But always, if you know the meaning, you will know which word is noun, which is starting noun, which one is objectives. I want you to start think, not only to get easy information. Copy this, do exercise or search on the internet to know the meaning. Then you will know which one is mubtada and which one is khabar. Yalla, copy that, boys. I need you to do. نعم يا مكاشفي. يا سيف شو بدك قول لي؟
أنا أخذت صورة عنها أو فيني أطبعها يعني بالبيت عندي برينتر عادي.
طيب ما هو إذا أنت بدك تطبعها طيب بس أنا بدي إياك تكون فاهم إنه هذه الجمل مش بس مبتدأ وخبر، هي مبتدأ وخبر صح لكن في إضافات. بدي إياك أنت تعرف المعنى عشان تعرف أي كلمة هي المبتدأ وأي كلمة الخبر.
أوكي.
ماشي أوكي يلا. So boys, I need you to copy this, please. Do search today at home for the meaning of this sentence. Then you will know which word is mubtada and which word is khabar based on noun and objectives. Okay, boys, please copy. Okay, I will read for you the sentences. المطالعة مفيدة. أخلاق الطفل عالية. الأب والأم أساس الأسرة. الطالبان نشيطان. قالت جدتي أنا ذكية. نحن شعب مناضل. So you need to do search, find out which word is mubtada, which word is khabar, and also find out which one is noun, which one is objectives. It can be many words, but of course the noun is, it can be more than one, but objectives is, it can be more than one, but we take only the first word, okay? Only the first word. We don't need to take all. Here, al-ab wal-um asas al-usra. So it can be the noun combined, but not combined. I mean, it can be more than one, but I needed the first one only. Try to do search to know the meaning. And also after that, I need you to tell me which one is mubtada, which one is khabar. Try to think, try to search. You will get the answers on the internet to know the meaning. Then after that, to know which one is mubtada, which one is khabar. Okay? Please finish copying this to be able to do it at home. And we will check it together again tomorrow. Adnan, what? Can you raise your voice? I cannot hear you, Adnan.
Mister.
Yes, Adnan.
I did the thing. Since there is 3 minutes remaining, should we go? Since we finish writing.
If you finish this, you finish copying this.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, boys. Did you finish copying this?
Yes, Mr.
Shukran, ya Muhammad.
Okay.
Yes, master.
Thank you, Nawaz. Ahmed Saleh, خلاص. مكاشفي خلصت؟
I finished.
شكرا يا أحمد. أوكي. سيف خلصت؟ أوكي.
Yes, mister.
شكرا. طيب. Boys, so as what we said, this is will be as a homework for tomorrow. You have time to go for the internet to search for the meaning of these sentences. I need you also, when you search for the meaning, I need you to know which one is mubtada, which one is khabar. It can be long sentence, but definitely first noun, we call it mubtada, then the objectives is khabar. You need to do this. Yeah, sure, no problem, Mukashfi. So please do this, and tomorrow when we are in the class, we will do it together to find out what you did. Is it correct or there is some mistakes here and there? Do your best. I know you are the best student. I know you can do it easily. Maybe you need just to do search on the net. Yes, John, is it correct? You need to do search on the net? I know that you are good in this. So Nawaz also, you can do that. Do search on the net, Nawaz. And John, and all of you, of course, find out what is the meaning of these sentences and where is the noun and objectives. It can be more than one noun, but I need the first noun and objectives. Then answer it here. And tomorrow when we are in the class, you will tell me which one is mubtada, which one is khabar, and we will do it together to check if we are right or not. Do you have any questions before we complete it? Yes, Mukashfi, tell me.
Mister. Mister.
Naam,
is there objective here? Is there objective here?
Is there objective? What do you mean that? I didn't know. I didn't understand. Kul jumla, each sentence has each sentence has mubtada and khabar.
And number three.
Of course, there is.
Question three. Does it have a objective?
طبعاً, أكيد.
And a subject?
Of course, no. Noun, which is mubtada, and objective is khabar.
You know,
the mic's on. Yes, Nawaz, tell me. Do you have any question, Nawaz?
No, I don't.
Okay. Ahmed Saleh, fadal.
Some sentences have more than three words.
كل جملة يا أحمد فيها مبتدا أو خبر. فهمت علي أحمد؟ كل جملة فيها مبتدأ أو خبر. So do your best today, students. We will see it tomorrow. Thank you all for attending.